is less than or equal to 75 MPa. And then for the bolt itself, shear stress on the bolt itself must be 45 MPa. So the question is, how much load can I safely carry? Right? So we are going to look at the different pieces individually, and we can see what is going on. So first, let us look at so the way to solve this is assume and check. This is our standard procedure. So assumption number one, the hanger will break. So what I mean by that, let me show you what I mean by that. Okay. So what I mean by that is maybe it will break here. Okay. So this is section assumption one. Assumption two is maybe it will break, this thing will break like that. So if I draw it out, so it's going to look like this, right? Maybe it will break here. Okay, or maybe it will break way up here. Or maybe the bolt will break. Bolt breaking means the portions of the bolt will slide away. You see, that's the head, that's the tail, and this bolt is coming down like that. You can see that there are two surfaces here that will slide. Okay, so we got to do each of them. So if the hanger breaks, so which means sigma hanger has reached sigma allowed, which is equal to, for the hanger it was 110 megapascals. That means P has to reach 38 times 13, which turns out to be 54.3 kilonewtons. So when the load reaches this value, the hanger will break. Well, maybe that's not what happens. Okay, let's check item number two. Maybe the top portion will break. Maybe this portion will break here. Can you see that? This portion, that's 2. Maybe this portion will break like that. For that, sigma allowed is 75 kilo megapascals, which means force must be, now look at the cross sectional area. Can you see it's that cross sectional area? If I look at it from the top, it will look like this. Can you see that? That's the cross hatched, that's the top, that's the cross sectional area. This whole thing is 75. this thing, the bolt size is 25. So F will be sigma allowed, which is 75 times, this is MPa, 75 minus 25 times thickness is still 13 mm, which turns out to be 48.7 mm. Sorry, MPa. Oh, sorry, kilonewtons. Notice, we have already concluded that this portion 2-2 is going to fail before the hanger fails, because if the load gets to 48.7 kilonewtons, that's going to, the side portions are going to fail. If the load gets to 54.3 kilonewtons, the hanger is going to fail. Now let us look at the bolt. This is the most interesting part. Third portion, maybe bolt fails. Well, let's look at the bolt. Looks like this. Here is the head, right? And in this middle portion, we are applying forces like this. So if I draw this chunk, it's going to be, here is the circle for this bolt, right? Looks like that, right? Here is the force P on this. So P over 2 will act on this side, P over 2 will act on that side. Area is A, area is A, right? So what happens is, this is shear stress, and the symbol is tau equals P over 2 divided by A. It's called double shear because two portions are sheared. Is that obvious to you? Everything, notice, we are always doing load analysis. You understand that? I have to draw a free body diagram to find out what's the load. Then I calculate the stress. In all of these cases, we are looking only at statically determinate systems. We don't care about deflection, so it's easy. Okay, so this is load analysis. And then we are computing the stresses. In our case, if the bolt fails, then tau must be equal to tau allowable, which is 45 megapascals, right? Which turns out to be, which implies the force must be 2 times 45 times area, because sigma, say tau equals P over 2A. So that turns out to be 2 times 45 times, what's this cross-sectional area? It's pi over 4 times 25 squared, which turns out to be 58 kilonewtons. Right? So, we looked at this. Let's see. This one, 54.3. So, the first, so if for the hanger to break, you have to get to 54.3 kilonewtons. For the lip of the hanger, this portion of the hanger to break, you have to get to 48.7 kilonewtons. For the bolt to break like that, you need 58 kilonewtons. So, you know that this is the weakest link. So, at this stage, that's what is going to fail. Okay. So, I want you to understand that local failures occur by shear. Things slide off. That's the method for it to fail, or because of some problems, because things are get smaller at the joints. Okay, so that's where we pay attention a lot when we design things, how things are connected. Okay, in this particular case, I showed you how to calculate the shear stress and check for shear failure. There's one more kind of failure that will occur, which is crushing.